Now recording.
Put to the first slide.
Good morning and welcome to the Peirce and Wastewater Treatment Facility Upgrade Construction Public Monthly Public Meeting. My name is Terry Damaris. We are doing this meeting by Zoom again this month due to the COVID outbreak. As a result of that, and per RSA, New Hampshire RSA 91A2, paragraph 3B. We are going to be doing this by Zoom and through the governor's executive order. We will be participating remotely. So at this time, I'm going to ask that you each introduce yourself, indicate where you are located, and who you are with. So my name is Terry Damaris. I'm at the Department of Public Works in my office by myself.
John Pearson with AECOM. I am also at the Department of Public Works in a conference room by myself.
Hello, I'm Andy Broder from Methuen Construction. I'm in an office by myself in the office trailer at the job site.
Great, thank you both. This month we updated the cover photo here to show the actual facility in place. A lot of times this, or in the past, this has been a rendering. You'll see in a later slide that there's a comparison of the two. Topics of discussions today, we'll go through introductions, work completed since last meeting, work to be completed in the coming month, and the number of following months, project construction costs, review the consent decree schedule, upcoming events and recreation, take public comments, if any, and move on for the time period of our next meeting. Again, my name is Terry Damaris. We do have a reminder here that there's a website that we update on a regular basis for the project. URL is listed here and generally provides information on news associated with the facility, some of the recreational information, traffic updates, and things like that. Also provides a location for reporting form if anybody has any issues associated with items related to the treatment facility construction. This time I'll pass it on to John Pearson, who will go through areas of ongoing construction.
Thank you, Terry, and good morning. This slide that's on the screen now shows a site plan of the facility as it will appear once construction is completed. And in the red circles and ovals, we've highlighted where there has been activity in the past month related to the ongoing construction of the treatment facility upgrade. So we will touch on each of those areas. But before we do that, Terry, if I could have the next slide. For reference, this is an aerial photograph looking to the east, showing the existing facility as it appeared in the fall of 2016, just as construction got underway. You can see there's some beginning excavation in the upper right corner in the area that ultimately has become the Headworks building. So for comparison to this slide, the next slide shows a more recent aerial photo of the facility construction. And again, this is also looking generally to the east, and you see the major areas of work activity highlighted in the red callouts. And we've got photographs to give you an update on what's been going on this month as construction has progressed. So we'll touch on each of these areas. Next slide, please. With the spring upon us, one of the major efforts in the past month has been final grading restoration work across the site. A couple of photographs here show some of the site work that has involved some extensive landscaping and planting. Photo on the right is the Pacassandra ground cover adjacent to the entrance to the solid building that had been placed on the slope. Photo on the left, you can see a building in the background. That's the Headworks building. This is just as you come up the road to the facility on the right, some of the landscaping to soften the appearance from the outside of the facility. Next slide, please. A couple of more photographs in the area of the Headworks building, which is the building in the background of both of these photos. You can see the various trees and shrubs and planting beds that have been constructed. And also in the background is the new perimeter fence. Portions of the new fence are in, and that work has been ongoing. Next slide, please. Moving to the south side of the site, behind the bath building, the south side of the building faces Shapley Island. These are some of the Virginia creeper vines being planted. On the photo on the right, it's more apparent, but you can see on the wall is a series of trellises These vines will grow and climb those trellises again to soften the appearance and make it blend with the surrounding vegetation. Those plantings were completed this past month. Next slide, please. As Terry mentioned, up until this meeting, the opening slide for each presentation has shown the rendering of the facility, which is the top photo on the slide. This rendering was prepared in 2016 in preparation for construction of the project. The bottom photograph is an actual photograph taken within the last month showing current conditions. And you can see by comparison that the two are quite close. The difference is trees are relatively new and haven't grown. The photo above indicates the trees at some point further down in time when the trees have grown a bit. But it generally, the rendering reflects the actual appearance of the building. And going forward, we'll be using the actual photograph rather than the rendering. Next slide. Other areas of work, as I mentioned, site work has been a big focus this past month. Some of the other site features, such as bollards to protect the equipment. Photo on the left shows a couple of the chemical fill stations where chemical trucks unload chemicals into the interior storage tanks, and they're protected by bollards from vehicular damage. Photo on the right shows the standby generator and the electric building in the background, again, protected by bollards from vehicular damage. And those were installed in the past month as well. Next slide. The other major area of focus this month has been the operations laboratory building. As we've talked in past months, this building was originally the sludge processing building for the facility. That function has now been transferred over to the new solids building, and the transformation of the old sludge processing building into the new operations laboratory building is well underway. Photo on the right shows from the, the east side of the building. You can see some of the brick facade is going up, as well as the sheathing and some of the others. Photo on the left shows the second floor, the metal framing that actually is the structure of the building, as well as the roofing deck has been installed. Next slide. A couple of other photographs. This is from the west side of the ops lab building looking east. So you're looking at what will become the main entrance to the operations lab building. The stairs have been placed. And some of the damp proofing on the exterior sheathing is ongoing. You see the black material as part of the construction. So the building itself, the exterior skin is well underway, and the roofing is also well underway. Next slide, please. Moving to the interior of the ops lab building, this photograph shows some of the interior metal stud walls that have gone up, as well as the beginnings of some of the plumbing rough-in. Some of the other trades, plumbing, electrical, mechanical, are beginning their rough-in process, and that's what you're seeing here. So this is the photograph of the first floor, which will be the administrative space for the facility. Next slide, please. A couple of more photographs of different areas within that first floor showing plumbing rough-in. The first floor will contain administrative offices, a SCADA control room, locker and toilet facilities for the treatment facility staff, and what you see here is some of the plumbing shower stalls going in as that begins to take shape. Next slide, please. The lower level of the ops lab building, which is completely separated physically from the first floor, still remains as a process space. In the basement will house the chemical feed systems for the disinfection process, as well as the plant water system, where some of the treated effluent from the facility is recycled for use throughout the facility for washdown and process water. And what you're seeing in these two photographs is some elements of the plant water system going in. Photo on the right is the plant water pumps and some of the piping being installed. Photo on the left is a strainer, because there is some material remaining in the treated effluent that the strainer removes that before it is distributed for use throughout the facility. So that work is well underway as well. Next slide, please. That is an overview of what's gone on this month. Let me turn the presentation over to Andy Broder for a discussion of what's coming up in the coming month, as well as a longer look ahead for the next 6 months.
Thanks, John. As far as work coming up in roughly the next month or so, there's still some minor finish work in some of the various buildings, the grit building, solids building, and bath building. We'll continue to work on the startup of the bath building process, as well as going back into the bath solids and grit buildings for some minor touch-up paint. Part of the building, the bath building process, is to continue that integration of the control system with the plant's SCADA system, so that'll be ongoing. We should be completing the startup of gravity thickener number two. Moving over to the operations building, you saw some of that interior work and the roofing system started, so we should be completing the roofing system, the interior metal stud framing, the interior masonry, and all the exterior brickwork at that building. Next slide, please. We'll also continue mechanical process work at the operations and lab building, as well as the HVAC electrical plumbing rough and plumbing roughing work at the lower level. You saw some pictures of the landscaping, so we'll be continuing the landscaping and work to bring that site up to final grade. Completing the placement of the asphalt access walkways, which are just walkways that connect the buildings, in between the buildings. We will complete the installation of the 12-foot wide vegetative maintenance corridor. We'll continue the installation of the chain link fence and gates that you saw in some of the photos before. Also continue the installation of the site lighting so we can get that online and start the installation of some of the other finished work. So it'll be granite curb and concrete block retaining walls. Looking out a little bit further, going out towards the end of the year, you saw the fence work that we talked about. So we'd be completing the fence gate system right at the Headworks building. As far as remaining punch lists, we'd be working in the grit building, bath and solids building to take care of that, as well as any fencing around those buildings. Again, the biggest thing that we have going right now is the operations building. So we plan on completing the following items. The exterior metal wall panel installation, the interior wall sheeting and painting, the installation of the laboratory casework and equipment in the lab at the east end of the building. We'd be completing all the rough-in work, so mechanical, electrical, plumbing, fire protection, and the process pipe and equipment. We would also be continuing finish work as far as mechanical, electrical, plumbing, and fire protection. We would complete the installation of the floor finishes and ceiling systems, complete the installation of all the exterior and interior doors and the windows, completing the installation of the chemical feed systems. On the outside of the building, we'd be completing the installation of all the exterior stairs. And then along with that, it would include the stair ramps and railings, and completing the installation of the bollards around the outside of the building at the overhead doors. As far as any other remaining site items go, we would finish installing the revised gratings at the PCE distribution box. And then for site work, we would be placing the remainder of the roadway paving, completing all the final grading and landscaping activities, and grading and placing any remaining stone mow strips around the buildings. And that's pretty much what we have looking forward, say, for the next 5 to 6 months.
I did want to add too that the city intends to add a trail along the backside of the facility site. While it's not shown here, it'd be on the Piscataqua Riverside, extending from the back right corner of the biological aerated filter up to the existing outlook, which you can see on this slide here over to the left underneath the word June. So that's a item that will get added into this work as well.
Thanks, Andy. Moving on to project construction costs, this slide summarizes the original contract amount, the 9 change orders that have been executed to date, and the total of just over $75 million is the total contract value for construction as of this month. Turning now to schedule.
John, I just wanted to add that all the change orders are listed on the city's project webpage for the Peirce Island Wastewater Treatment Facility project. And what we attempt to do in each one of those is provide a summary of all the items that are in the change order. So generally, while these are usually lengthy documents, the first 3 or 4 pages that are available as a link on the website provide a summary of all the major items that go into the final cost that you see here for each individual change order. Sorry.
That's okay. Moving on to schedule, this slide summarizes the consent decree milestones that were contained in the consent decree between the city and EPA for the project. And the one, they've all been achieved with the exception of the remaining one, is to achieve compliance with consent decree total nitrogen as of June 1st. So June 1st has passed, but the data is collected for the month of June, reported in mid-July. And so we'll be able to report probably for next month's meeting how we're doing. But we do have some data to show, as we have in the last couple of months, to give you a sense of how things are working. This slide shows two parameters, total suspended solids, which is abbreviated TSS, a measure of the amount of solid material in the wastewater, and biochemical oxygen demand, or BOD, a measure of the organic strength. Both of those parameters are limited by the city's National Pollutant Discharge Elimination System permit, which governs the requirements for the effluent to be discharged. They require that those two parameters can't exceed a monthly average of 30 milligrams per liter. What we're showing here is for the months of February through May, the actual discharge levels that were discharged, with the TSS in blue and the BOD in the reddish color. Both are well below the limit of 30 milligrams per liter.
John, I just want to point out that based on the compliance requirements in the city's consent decree, the requirement to meet that 30 milligram per liter limit did not change from a discharge monitoring report perspective until April 1st. So while we did meet those numbers in February and March, we were not required to, at least from the standpoint of reporting on our discharge monitoring reports.
The other parameter is total nitrogen, and this is contained in the consent decree rather than the NPDES permit. Again, it took effect June 1st, a monthly average of 8 milligrams per liter, and the four bars present the data for February through May as it continues to decline downwards towards the 8 level. And so we are optimistic that things will be achieved come June. Next slide. Typically at this point, we would talk about some of the scheduled Peirce Island related recreational events that are ongoing so that we coordinate the construction with them. But with the COVID situation, there are none scheduled at this time.
At this point in the presentation, we typically take public input and comments. There were no pre-registrants for this particular meeting, but I do want to remind those who might see this on YouTube or are otherwise concerned about any items that they can email me directly at tldemaris or tldesmaris at cityofportsmouth.com, and I will get your questions addressed. So move on to the date of our next meeting, which will be in about a month, July 15th, 2020 at 11 a.m. And the specific format will be determined at that point in time, depending on how the COVID response continues. Thank you very much. Okay, I'm going to end the meeting so we can generate the recording. All set.